Hey guys, welcome back to RWM Finance. And do you know what the best investment is that you can make? If you don't, stick around. So if you haven't subscribed, please scroll down and click that subscribe button and we will move right on into the topic. So what is the best investment that you can make? Alright? Well, you think about that, but I'll tell you the answer. The best investment that you can make is an investment in yourself. An investment in yourself is the greatest investment that you can make because it will last you for the rest of your life. Okay, so in my video about why the poor stay poor, which I have provided a link to you up above, I said that the poor stay poor because they invest in stuff and not in themselves. You do not invest in yourself. How do you expect to learn and grow? Our learning should not stop once we're done with school. In fact, that is when the real personal development begins, is once we are done with our school. Bill Gates, who is the creator of Microsoft, says that he reads over 50 books a year. And he does that because he feels that it gives him an advantage over his competition. Do you realize how much information can be in 50 books? I mean, there can be a lot of information in just one book, but 50 books? Holy cow! Do you realize how much you can learn from 50 books? But more importantly, do you realize how much you can learn, grow, develop, evolve, change from just reading one book? It only takes one book to change who you are and get you on the path of becoming who you want to be. I can tell you what book did it for me. It was Money by Tony Robbins. I don't know what happened, but I had just changed my major from engineering to business, and I was just killing some time in the library, and I don't know why I picked it up, but I picked it up and sat down and started reading it. And, you know, I had a lot of guys tell me, you know, why are you reading a book? Why are you, you know, reading that big of a book? You're never going to finish it. Why are you even doing that? Just put it back. But, you know, I started reading it and kept reading it. And finally, I finished it. And that book is what did it for me. Now I've just decided that, you know, I want to continue learning, not just with what I learn in school, but I want to learn outside of that. I want to personally develop myself so I can be better. That book has helped shape me into, you know, who I am today. And I mean, it's not just that book. I mean, there's a lot more that goes into it than just books. Now I've started reading a lot and I've accumulated quite a bit of books just about various topics, mainly personal finance. So I guess my point is, I don't think you should just go out there and try and like read 50 books as fast as possible, because you know that's a hard goal to try and meet, and it's kind of it's a daunting task, and it's kind of intimidating. But you know, just start with one book. And I wanted to make this video right now because I feel like that a lot of us have quite a bit of time on our hands, so you might as well spend this time trying to better yourself, trying to develop, you know, learn new things. You know, there's nothing wrong with picking up a book and learning something new. In fact, if you don't use this time to your advantage and try and learn something new, then, you know, you didn't lack the information or the ability to do it. You lacked the discipline to do it. So there's two types of investments you can make. There's investments into like assets and stuff like that, which I've talked about and I've made some videos over. But there's also investments in yourself, which is what this video is over. And I feel like that you should use this time to invest in yourself so you can better yourself to invest in those assets and stuff that we've talked about. Because before you should go and try and invest into those assets, you should try and invest into yourself to help you gain some knowledge about those types of investments. You should invest into yourself, that way you can improve your investments into assets. So read a book, take a course, go online and find a YouTube video. There is plenty of free and accessible information that you can get your hands on. That way you can learn and grow and develop yourself and just figure things out about different topics. There's so much information out there that you can get your hands on. It's not like you have to go and pay for things. You know, you have the internet, which is a great tool to use to your advantage to give you access to all that stuff. And I'm not saying you have to go and learn about finances. I mean, an investment in yourself, whether it's about, you know, thinking positive. The Power of Positive Thinking by Norman Vincent Peale is a great book on that. Finances, that's one that I'm talking about. But cooking, I mean, there's so much stuff. How to start a business. There's so much stuff that you can go and learn about. Speaking from a finance standpoint, if you want to learn about investing into stocks, bonds, real estate, you know, things like that, then pick up a book, take a course, go online, search stuff, look at videos on YouTube. The thing is, it's not going to hurt you. All that stuff is just going to better you. If you want to improve your finances, then a great place to start would be to increase your financial literacy. You know, learn the terms, learn why things go certain ways, why certain stocks go up at certain times and down at others. I mean, learn why real estate can help produce tons of cash flow for you. Learn things. I mean, that stuff that you learn can be so valuable to you. And once you learn it, the sky is the limit, because that knowledge is yours forever. No one's going to be able to take that away from you. It's yours. Use it. Learn it. Use it. Grow it. Keep learning. There's no point in stopping. If you invest in yourself and learn and grow, there's so much advantages to that. It allows you to become better prepared for what lies ahead. You know, I mean, if you learn something right now, then you'll be better prepared for whatever happens to you in the future, because you have that information in your head. Think about your future self, you know, 1 year, 2 years, 3 years ahead. Like, what's he doing? What's he or she doing? What are they like? Where is he at that time? If you like what you see in your future self, great. Keep going on the path that you're on. You know, that's fantastic. But if you don't, if you have doubts about what that future self is doing, where he's at, and you don't think that you're going to like what he's doing, the only way that you can change where he's at is to change what you're doing right now. Change the path that you're on right now. So, invest in yourself right now, and your future self will thank you. So I challenge you. Don't try to go out and, you know, do too much, but dive in. Dive into one book, one course, one video, and see where that takes you. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please go down, give it a like, and subscribe to the channel. And, you know, if you have any other tips on investing in yourself, or if you have a success story of, you know, things were going downhill, things were bad, you were in a bad situation, and you picked yourself up, you invested in yourself, and you grew, and now you've changed that situation, leave it down in the comment section. Tell us, you know, we'd love to hear success stories like that. So thank you all for watching, and I will see y'all in the next video.